I just raised a big Siberian tiger, Ming, and I inherit the name Tiger Man. I had him his whole life. The world definitely need to know that. I raised him from a little smaller than this here. People saying that they knew. Not true. You know, he never even journeyed outside the apartment.
Well, this guy walks into the hospital with some bites, and he tries to convince the doctors that these are from a dog attack.
This paparazzi saying that I was mauled by a tiger. I only think Ming got it in him to do that. They trying to give me like 40 years based on a tiger. But I can't tell the public, I can't tell the world that I've been doing this since I've been 3 years old. And like I said, I done raised almost everything except for like a hippopotamus or elephant. But I'm about to go there. I studied over 15,000 species of plants. I know over 200,000 stars. I know every species of animal on this planet. The media never let out to the general public about some of my abilities or some of the things I have done or created. Every tiger have his own distinct markings. That's how I can know my tiger from anywhere in the world. You put him in a room with 1,000 tigers, I know him. He weighed about 450 pounds. They huge. Paws alone, like big enough, like cover my chest really. Like meat hooks almost, you know? Dangerous. But I never feared that. You know, the public first said that, and I still hear it today when I read these papers, saying that I was mauled by a tiger. If I was molded, I got all my body limbs in. I feel good. I love Roy to death, but I hate to say this, but Roy was molded. If you look in the definition of molded, it means mistreated, mishandled, tossed around. I wasn't none of that. My technique in building trust, you gotta love them first. You know what I mean? It gotta be a true love. It can't be just saying I love this animal or I love animals. I mean, it gotta be real. Like, if this animal was sick, I was there for him. You know what I mean? If this animal wanted somebody to play with, I was there for him. It wasn't never a lack of abandonment. So our bond is like close-knit, tight. I once put him in the bathroom because I was cleaning and everything, and he looked in the mirror for the first time. It's the first time he ever seen his reflection. You talking about a 500-pound tiger that's looking in the mirror. He went to slap the mirror off. Now, this goes to show you about this domestication I'm talking about. So he never knew he was a tiger. What I did was journeyed a little farther than what anybody else can do. What I did was implant his freedom up here first, and that's first and foremost. You know what I mean? So once that freedom is embedded to him, and I never try to take away his predatorial instinct. I never tried that. What I did was curved it. And the rest just came natural. It's a gift. But I just want to clear up the fact that I was never attacked by me. The media need to stop airing that out. What happened was that I had found the little house cat. I came in, me, charged him. I jumped in front of him and I took the bite for the little cat. The bite was a test to me, showing my true love. It's a test to see if I can really get out of condition. A test to see was I able to deal with this big cat. I wanted to be the best in what I do. I did something that really made me happy. And I give this advice to everybody and anybody. If you can find something that can make you happy, do it.